Hi, I'm JB from Huffy, and today I'm going to be helping you build your 26-inch Huffy Exxo mountain bike. We have everything that came in the box laid out here on the table, and we're going to go ahead and get started. Just to start, you may want to leave the plastic fork guard in place if you're working on a delicate surface like a kitchen table or something like that. You can also use cardboard or a piece of old carpet, a doormat, something like that. And we're going to start at the back of the bicycle. We're going to go ahead and put the derailleur guard on. It is this piece right here. And it goes where these two Phillips head screws are. So you can go ahead and remove those. If these are too tight to remove by hand, the included tools also have Phillips head screwdrivers on the ends of them, and you can use those to remove them. Go ahead and put it in place. And you can use a Phillips head screwdriver to set these in place. Or if you don't have a Phillips head screwdriver handy, like I said earlier, there is a Phillips head screw head attachment on both of the Allen wrenches included with the bike. And they just need to be hand tight. You don't have to really put a whole lot into those, otherwise you may damage the screw heads. All right, now we're going to go ahead and move to the pedals. There is a left and right pedal. They are marked. Left pedals typically have a blue or green sticker on them, and the right pedal has a red or orange sticker on it. The sticker on the pedal does indicate which way you turn to tighten as well. The right pedal is righty-tighty. The left pedal is a little bit different from the norm. It is lefty-tighty, and that's the only thing that's a bit backwards on this bike and on any bike in general. So we're going to go ahead and get these pedals just hand-started. We'll go with the right one here. And you want to run these into the cranks by hand as much as possible. This helps prevent any stripping or thread damage. And in case there's any confusion, the right side of the bike is always the rider's right, so if you hear us refer to right side, that's what we mean. The right side is also the side with the chain and drivetrain on it. Once we get those pedals hand tight, we'll go ahead and use the provided wrench. Or if you have a 15 millimeter wrench, you can use that as well. You want to make sure that the pedals are very tight. So that they do not come off when you are riding the bicycle. Next, we're going to move to adding the seat. The seat and seat post come as two different pieces. You'll take the smaller end of the seat post and insert it into the hole in the bottom of the seat. Make sure that it goes all the way down and hits the seat post stop. We're going to go ahead and just try to get an idea of where we want it. You can adjust this a little bit more later. This is also a 15 millimeter nut on the hardware here, and you want, when you're tightening these, to see equal amounts of bolt come through each side. So if there's about 2 millimeters of bolt coming out over here, we want to tighten this nut on this side so there's about the same amount coming through. And if you do have a 15 millimeter socket and ratchet, it may speed up this process for you just a little bit. So So now that we have that tightened up a little bit, we'll go ahead and test fit the seat post into the seat tube. You'll do this by loosening the quick release mechanism and inserting the post. I'm just going to let it rest on the reflector, and I'm going to tighten the thumb screw just a little bit in the back and go ahead and close the quick release. So it looks like we have a little bit of movement. Go ahead and open that back up just a little bit and give the thumb screw one more turn. You do want this lever to be a little bit difficult to close. It does need to have some good tension on it so that it grips the seat post and prevents it from going up and down or left and right. If you do have a little bit of movement only in the top section here where it's the seat and not the actual seat post, you just need to tighten up the 15 millimeters, the nuts on the bottom of the seat, just a little bit more. If you loosen those, you can adjust the angle of the seat as well, and that'll help you get a better fit for when you're actually sizing up the bike for when you want to ride it. All right, so we're going to go ahead and move to the front of the bike. Now the handlebars do come off of the bike in the package, so it may take a little bit of finagling to kind of figure out how they need to loop around. Typically you need to flip them upside down from the way they're packaged. You want to make sure that all of the wire housings are below the handlebars, and so that the stem doesn't have anything coming over it and to the bike. Go ahead and put this in. If you need to, you can use the largest Allen wrench we provide to loosen this up a little bit so that you can fit the wedge in there. Should look something like this when you have it in there. No tangles here, and all the wires and housings are free to kind of move around. I will mention there are some marks on the stem here. You'll see some dashes that go around the handlebar stem. This is the minimum mark here, so you want to make sure if you're adjusting this to fit you that those marks are at least inside of the head tube, and that's for safety. You'll see those same marks on the seat post as well, so make sure that you are putting those to at least the minimum mark. So we'll go ahead and tighten this down. And this is just going to be kind of a preliminary tight. Doesn't have to be tightened down all the way, because you will loosen this to adjust the handlebars so that they match the front wheel so that you're steering straight. All right, so now that you have that hand tight, you can go ahead and release the front brake mechanism and pull the wire housing free on the other side. And then we'll go ahead and add the front wheel at this time. So we'll go ahead and grab the front wheel here. When putting the front wheel on, you want to check your tread orientation. So when you put this on, you want the tread to match the orientation that was done on the rear of the bike. So I'm going to turn this one around so it matches. And then I'm also going to loosen the 15 millimeter bolts, or nuts rather, that are on the axle so that they're as far out as I can get them. And then I'm also going to pull out the dropout washer so that it's against those nuts as we're going. I'm going to go ahead and lift this up. I'm actually going to take this plastic spacer out this time and then put the wheel in. Slide it between the brakes. Move the washers to the outside if they moved around on you. And kind of wiggle everything into place and make sure that the wheel and tire are centered. Now you're going to take the dropout washer and you're going to move it so that the hook goes into the hole on the fork. And that is right there. And then go ahead and run down the nuts by hand. Let's give everything a little bit of a shake again. And if you're working by yourself, now's a good time to go ahead and put that kickstand down so that you can work on the bike without having to hold it up too much. If you do have someone else around, it's always a good idea to have them help you out, if possible, keeping the bike level. So I'm going to tighten these 15 millimeters little by little on each side, making sure that I keep the wheel and tire centered. And once they're tight, you can go ahead and reattach the brake housing to the brakes. In the event that you can't get that over and you do need to add a little bit of wire into the brake system to get that over, you can use the middle Allen wrench we provide to you, and you can loosen right here and get a little bit more tension there. In the event that you feel like you need to adjust that, this should always be open when you're doing that. You can loosen that just a little bit, just enough to get some wire movement there, and then tighten it back into place. Just be careful not to over-tighten. If you do, you could damage the wire and could cause the brakes to fail. So now we're going to go ahead and check the brakes to see if they're adjusted properly. We're going to look at brake pad position. Make sure that the brake pads aren't touching the tire and that they are lined up with the rim on each side. All right. And then we're going to squeeze the lever a couple times just to see if we need to make any adjustments. In this case, we do need to make some adjustments. The right side of the bike, the brake is not moving as much as on the left side of the bike. So we're going to fix that by adding some tension to the spring on the right side. You can use a Phillips head screwdriver or the Phillips head attachment on the Allen wrench to do this. You're going to use the adjustment screw that is on the brake. Each side has one. We're going to go to the side that's not moving as much. I'm going to go ahead and give it a couple turns to tighten that screw in, and we're going to try and see if that changes anything. We'll give it a couple more turns. We're getting a little bit of movement out of it. I'm going to check the other side to see how much is on there, and so we'll loosen this one up just a little bit. All right, so it looks like we're getting movement on both sides now. That's what we want to see. We want to see equal movement on the left and right side of the brake. Just give it a little bit of spin there. So if you need to adjust the brake pads, say the brake pad is not lined up with the rim, or the brake pad is touching the tire when you pull the lever, you can simply use the middle Allen wrench that we provide you. Loosen the brake pad slightly. You do not need to take the hardware all the way out. And adjust as necessary. Move it up and down, left or right. It does have a little bit of a swivel to it. Once you get it where you need it, go ahead and tighten it up. I typically try to hold the pad in place with my fingers while I'm doing this. If the pad is moving a lot while you're tightening, try to hold it a little bit better, or you may be over-tightening. This just needs to be good and snug. It doesn't need to be on super, super tight. We'll go ahead and squeeze the lever, make sure we're still meeting up with the rim where we need to. Next, we're going to adjust our handlebars. So this time you're going to get the larger of the three Allen wrenches, and you're going to loosen up the handlebar attachment on the stem. Once you've gotten it appropriately loose, go ahead and rotate it around. This bike is equipped with grip shift, and you'll notice the arrow right here that indicates what gear you're in. We like to have that arrow pointing towards the rider so that they can see where they're at. And we've set that up from the factory in the most popular position, so you can see how the rake of the handlebars kind of puts it in the right area. We also like to have around a 30 degree angle on the brake levers, so you can see how they're angled down slightly, and that's to create a little bit better angle for the way your wrist sits on the handlebars. And we'll go ahead and tighten this down so that the handlebars don't move when riding. So we've gotten that tight. We can also check to make sure that the handlebars and the front wheel are lined up. Same Allen wrench, the larger of the three. You can loosen the stem, adjust as necessary, and then tighten. You can go ahead and finish up by moving the reflector down so that it is facing forward. You're also going to find a little rubber cap inside your owner's manuals bag. That's this little cap right here, and it simply goes on to the hardware on the top of the stem. All right, so now we're at the back of the bike, and we're going to go ahead and check our rear brake to make sure that it is functioning properly. Adjustment is exactly the same as on the front, so I'll go ahead and squeeze that. We have good movement on the left and right side of that, and our pad placement is perfect. We just want to make sure that the derailleur is in good shape when we start. The derailleur is typically on the largest cog when it's shipped to you. I've shifted this one down to the bottom just so I can see the start. You want to make sure that this cage on the derailleur hasn't been bent in or out, and that it is still in line with the cogs on the cassette. Looking at ours, it looks to be in good shape. If you need to move this cage in or out so that it is more in line, you can do that with the adjustment screw on the back of the derailleur here. Turning it counterclockwise, move it in, and clockwise, we'll move it out. Just go ahead and put the kickstand up. Give the bike a few pedals to make sure that there's no odd noises or clicks. And then we'll go ahead and shift the rear gear cassette up the cassette a little bit so that we can make sure that we have good travel. You can safely go through two gears at a time with this system. All right, making sure that we're in the largest gear here. And it looks like we're good. I'm going to go ahead and put the kickstand back down and check the position of the cage. And it looks like it's lined up really well. If you do have shifting difficulties, the system is a little complex to be able to adjust on your own, and you may want to consult a bike shop or a bike technician and have them adjust it for you. One last thing to check on your bike would be the tire pressure. The tire pressure is listed on the side of the tire. In this case, it has a maximum of 50 PSI, so make sure that the tires are inflated before you go riding. There is a chance that your tires will be pretty low or flat when you get the bike. It has been on a long journey and lots of travels to get to you. So now you can get out there and enjoy your bike. Make sure to always wear a helmet and obey local laws. And once again, my name is JB from Huffy, and I hope that you're able to get out there and have some fun.